It's time for the match game, Hollywood Squares. Our with from Dallas, Audrey Landers. Fred Travelena. From the Fall Guy, Markie Post. Arsenio Hall. Nedra Volz. And the stars of the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn. Shawn.
Oh, live ones.
Yeah. And you notice every seat is filled.
Amazing.
Well, we must be a big draw, John.
Apparently, Gene.
Yes. Welcome, one and all, and thank you for showing up here on this rainy day. Nice to have you with us. Shall we have a go at it?
Why not?
What are we
going to
do?
I don't know. Why don't you host Match Game?
How about doing Hollywood Squares?
Okay.
All right, let's begin by asking these lovely people to give our stars a big round of applause. Hello, stars!
Well, that's
nice to see all of your bodies.
Some especially, I will say.
You don't think I'm glad to see your body?
How could you be?
I'm glad to see your body.
He doesn't care whose body he sees.
Welcome, one and all. Some of you have been here before. Some of you haven't. Let's see. Who's the only new kid on the block is this one here.
Yeah. Is that
welcome.
True?
Let's give her up.
Thank you. Thank you.
Just the stars. A brisk round of applause for Markie. Oh. Welcome to our house.
Thank you.
You're
going
to have a wonderful time here.
I'll have no doubt.
It's a whole spontaneous thing. Now let's greet our two players over here, Angelique Weathersby and Fern Casher.
Hey.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Let's get acquainted. Angelique, tell us about you, please.
Hi, Jean. I'm a nurse in Redlands. I work in the intensive care unit. I just got back from Mazatlan, Mexico, and I had a really good time.
Really? What'd you do down there?
I did some snorkeling, and I ate out at a different place every night.
No kidding.
Oh, yeah.
Take my pulse. Well, she knows how to do it. She is a nurse. Okay. Now, let's get acquainted with Fern.
Well, I'm a singer, and I'm originally from New Jersey, and I'm going to make a terrible wife because I hate to cook and sew.
Well, that's being very candid, and she's telling the whole world about that right now. What sort of things do you sing?
Songs.
Fred will do the jokes. You did it. No.
A live
you
one.
You do contemporary stuff?
Or? Yeah, everything you hear on the radio.
Okay. All right. We'll tune you in sometime, Fern. Now, you won the toss, Angelique. That means you go first.
I'd like A, please.
All right. You've got it. Harry said. He said, this $20 bill is a fake. Instead of Andrew Jackson, it's got a picture of blank Jackson. No help from the audience. Let them figure it out themselves.
Just stick it in, babe.
Angelique. Harry said this $20 bill is a fake. Instead of Andrew Jackson, it's got a picture of blank Jackson.
Reggie Jackson.
Reggie Jackson. Famous baseball player. What did you say?
Oh, no.
Oh, no what?
I had Reggie, and then I changed it to Michael Jackson.
You scratched out Reggie and put Michael. Well, I tell you, you thought of the really good two answers to this question here. There may be others. I don't know. Fred?
Well, Ollie.
What?
I certainly thought it would be a good answer, and I did the same thing that she did, see? I wrote down an answer, and I crossed it out. First I wrote Jesse, then I wrote Michael.
Uh-huh.
So,
she's still looking. What do you say?
Gosh, I was in my dressing room trying to walk backwards and make it look like I was going forward. And,
why were you doing
what
that?
Was on my mind.
Yes. Michael. Well, Reggie is what Angelique wants there. Give her Reggie, would you?
Sure, why not?
Reggie
Oh,
Jackson.
Thank you.
Okay, Markie, instead of Andrew Jackson, it's got a picture of Reggie Jackson, according to Angelique. What do you say?
I'm so sorry.
Michael Jackson. All right. And what do you got?
Michael.
Nedra has Michael. Boy, would you have done well with Michael.
Oh, wow. Nedra.
You would have had five. All right, but you got one. That's good.
Nedra used to date Michael Jackson, as a
man. Nedra used to date Michael. How was he?
Well, better than nothing.
All right. Fern, this is for you. Elwood the Undertaker used to work in a laundry. When you die, he doesn't put your body in a coffin. He blanks it. Understand? When you die, he doesn't put your body in a coffin. He blanks it. It's because he used to work in a laundry.
Oh, yeah.
Ready on the top? Put it in the slot, Fred. Thank you. Fern, here we go. I guess yours is not in the slot yet, is it?
Over the hump.
Oh, I'm so bad.
Well done.
All right. Over the hump and just stick it in.
You're going to get 40 lashes for that in my dressing room after the show, Markie. Elwood the Undertaker used to work in a laundry, Fern. And when you die, he doesn't put your body in a coffin. He blanks it.
He puts it in a washing machine.
He puts it in a washing machine. He blanks it. What other things do laundry people do?
Bleaches it.
He bleaches your body. What else? What else?
Cleans it.
He cleans it. Well, anyway, there are any number of things. Okay, Audrey.
Like
when you die, he doesn't put your body in a coffin. What does he do to it?
I said he washes it.
He washes it. All right.
For
Fern. I guess that happened in the laundry, Fred.
Well, Rochester, I was thinking about bones, you see, and bodies, so I said, bleaches it.
He bleaches it.
Right.
Bleach laundry, the bones. Right, of course, they do that in the laundry.
This audience is left over from an old concentration game, I think. I'm not sure. It washes it.
Boo, you stink, we hate you. You know,
but we love you, and I said washes, Fern. I'm
washes.
Sorry.
All right, super Fern. Elwood the Undertaker used to work in a laundry. When you die, he doesn't put your body in a coffin.
I thought there was an inventive thing to do to a body. He starches it.
Very good. Another good possibility. Do you have one of the good possibilities, Markie?
Well, I thought the same thing. If it wasn't stiff enough, he'd starch it.
He'd starch it. All right. That's hello, Nedra.
He quick dries it.
He quick dries it. So there we are at the end of round one. 2-1 is the score. A tight game going here. Round two coming up in a moment or so. But now we have this for you, if you please.
Now.
Yeah, here we go. Round two, if you're ready. I'll push the button. Fern, you're ahead. That means you have to go first.
Hey.
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 Hey, Ray Jean.
Hey. Bill said to nearsighted Ned, remember those words, Bill is speaking to nearsighted Ned. He said, what are all those horrible marks on your face? And Ned said, when the phone rang in the kitchen, I answered the blank.
Mr. Rayburn?
Interesting possibilities?
I don't get to write.
You don't get to write because you matched in the previous
round.
You
get to relax.
You don't play because you matched in the previous round. One more time. There you go.
That's a nice suit.
Thank you very much.
I looked for the dark gray.
Yes.
I couldn't find it.
This is called Banker's Gray.
Banker's Gray.
This is
called Pimp Gray. It's an interesting color. Good to be back, Gene.
Fred's just about ready. Shall we come over here to Fern and put it to her? Bill said to nearsighted Ned, what are all those horrible marks on your face? And Ned said, when the phone rang in the kitchen, I answered the blank.
Waffle iron.
Waffle iron.
Wish I thought of that.
You didn't think of that?
No.
That's a pretty good one.
Fantastic.
Well, I said that...
There are a couple of other good ones. You may have it.
Yes, well, I said he answered the popcorn maker. Bing, 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 bing,
right,
bing,
bing, bing, bing, bing, bing. Speaking of nifty looking dress, I mean, I love the collar bar you're wearing. I'm wearing one too. And look at his. I've never seen one like that. Isn't that nifty?
Oh, yeah, that's
chain?
Real cute. He used to live with Richard Simmons, though, I think.
I want to tell you something, and that's why the popcorn maker is so important to your home. And let's get with it. And one, and two, and three.
All right, now we come to you, John.
Oh,
what are the horrible
marks on
your face?
I was having such a good time watching them, yes.
When the phone rang in the kitchen, I answered the blank.
Yes, well, I answered the waffle iron, don't you love me?
You're up to three now. Hello, Markie, darling.
Hello. And I answered the waffle iron.
Ah, well, that's a turn. Four for Fern. Nedra shaking her head.
And I answered the blender.
The blender. That's good, Nedra. That'll put some scars on your face. A perfectly good response. Now, Angelique, let's see if you catch up to Fern with this. Hey, did you hear that evil Knievel just made his strangest jump yet? Strange.
Strange.
You're stuck.
Who asked you?
Not as strange as that response.
He went to the worst part of New York City and jumped over 10 blanks laid end to end. You don't think that was strange? That was strange. Okay?
All right.
Here we go. Did you hear that Evil Knievel just made his strangest jump yet, Angelique? He went to the worst part of New York City, and he jumped over 10 blanks laid
muggers.
End to end.
Muggers.
10 muggers.
Oh, yeah. Great.
There are a number of good possibilities here. Mugger is a possibility. Not a great one, but a possibility.
Well, I didn't have one of the great possibilities, both of mine. I changed from garbage cans to junk cars.
To junk cars. Well, you see a lot of those in New York. They abandon them.
Well, being that I grew up in New York City, and it now looks like East Berlin in many parts of the city.
Only in the South Bronx.
I went back there last week, and I said hi to somebody, and he went, "Umuzo Nagata." I said vacant buildings.
Oh, vacant buildings. Oh, that'd be tough.
Able to leap 10 vacant buildings in a single bath.
I think I have a good answer.
You have a good answer.
I'm not from New York, but I was in New York. I asked a guy, you know how New York is. People aren't real friendly, and, people come to you.
Huh? It's a turn.
Never mind. I was going with my answer. I had to put muggers. I mean.
You had to put muggers.
Thank you.
Well, thank you. Okay. 4-2 the score now, Angelique. All right, you lay out. And how about you, Markie? What have you got for us?
The worst part of New York City, right? The worst part.
Yes, the worst part.
Bums.
Very good answer. Excellent. Hello, Nedra.
Police cars.
I love that answer.
Well, there'd be a lot of police cars in the worst part of New York City, I suppose.
There should be.
Where are we now? 4-2. She's still ahead. You got another round to catch up, and that'll happen right after this happens. Here we go! It's the third and final round for these two ladies. Fern, you're still ahead, 4-2, so you have to go first.
I'll stick with A.
A it is. You had that all along, haven't you? Maurice said. He said, you get some weird requests being a taxidermist here in Hollywood. Just last week, I had to stuff Joan Rivers blank. Only
write.
Two people play. You don't play.
Fred, I don't get to write.
And Nedra are the only two who play this round because all the others matched in the previous. They're very good, Nedra. You got the idea there.
He's got the idea.
Stick it in there. We come over here to Fern Casher.
Take it away, Uncle Gene.
Morris, thank you. You get some weird requests being a taxidermist here in Hollywood. Just last week, I had to stuff Joan Rivers blank.
Wait.
I love her, but her mouth.
Her mouth.
Weird answers. Good answer.
Oh, she kids herself, doesn't she, about having a big mouth?
Yeah, well, she knows. Yeah, she does. And she's always, Elizabeth Taylor would probably have made the same request. But she works with David Brenner. David Brenner a lot. David and Joan work a lot. You know what's really stupid?
What?
Stuff the mouth.
Her mouth.
Right.
All right, Fern, you're up to 5. Hello, Nedra.
Hello, Gene.
How are you?
I don't know.
You look good to me.
Well,
I love
you've
the.
You've been spoiled.
Yes. I love the knot on the top of your head. Yeah. Is that all your real hair?
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah, it comes down clear down here.
Uh-oh. Don't show. No show and tell. Just show us your answer.
Bra.
Stuffed her bra.
She's always complaining about
that. Was the other good possibility. Mouth and bra were the two good answers there. Now, Angelique, you need 3 to tie and 4 to win. You can do it. Don't give up. Angelique, think and listen carefully now. The people in low IQ village are so stupid. I think that's an improvement, don't you? Yes. Here's how stupid they are. The biggest business in town is a do-it-yourself blank parlor. All right, Arsenio and John are the two who do not play. The others do.
I don't mind not writing with Mr. Rayburn.
Yeah.
I just want to be here.
Audrey, are you ready?
No. Well, yeah.
Yes, no, yes, no, yes, no, yes. Now we may have your answer, if you please.
Could you repeat it one more time?
One more time. The people in Low IQ Village are so stupid, the biggest business in town is a do-it-yourself blank parlor.
The only thing I could think of is a beauty parlor.
Do-it-yourself beauty parlor. Yes. Well, that would be difficult, wouldn't it, to do your own hair? That's one possibility. What did you say?
I said a beauty parlor.
A beauty parlor.
Thank you.
See, I told you.
I couldn't think of anything else either.
Really?
See, you just follow your first thought.
All right, you need two more to achieve a tie. And let's see what happens here now. Fred.
Well, I'll tell you something.
What?
That sounded like common sense to me. I come from a town, it is the lowest IQ you've ever heard in your life. Golly. We had a do-it-yourself breathing parlor.
A breathing parlor.
Breathing?
All right, now you must match two returning ones, Angelique, to stay in the game. And they are Markie and Nedra. Markie, may we see yours, please? She's looking for beauty parlor.
Massage parlor.
Massage parlor, so that means Fern Casher wins the game.
That's good.
You. Hang around here. I'll be with you in a moment or so. I want to say goodbye to Angelique.
Thank you. I had
pleasure.
A lot of fun.
Good, Angelique. We're going to send some gifts to you. Many thanks for being here on Match Game. Angelique Weathersby. There she goes.
Thank you.
Here you are. Congratulations to you. Now we're going to switch to Hollywood Squares. We're going to bring in three more celebrities. Look at the set we're bringing in here for those three celebrities. There are three places. And I'm going to trade places with the host of Hollywood Squares. That's this fellow right here, John Bauman. We've got lots more excitement coming your way, so don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Sierra Online Action Games and a home computer. Includes Frogger and the classic space game Threshold. Designed for family fun. Furnished by Sierra Online. And now, it's time for more of The Match Game. Hollywood Squares. Our with from Days of Our Lives, Sean Stevens. From Goodnight Beantown, Jim Staahl.
I was zonked.
And now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Thank you, Gene Wood. Thank you. Okay, welcome everybody to the second half of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. And we have with us Fern Casher, who made a clean sweep of the Match Game contest. She is now ready to move on. We also have three brand new celebrities, Sean, Blake, and Jim. Yeah, yeah, I see that. Sean, you know, we haven't really been on the air a whole long time yet, but you are the first celebrity to appear on Hollywood Squares with your own frog.
Probably be the last.
Is there an explanation for this, or?
Catches flies.
Well, actually, it's good luck. He goes with me everywhere. I have a collection of these things, and this one brings good luck to
How many frogs do you have, Sean?
I have, at last count, around 1,000.
1,000? And where do you get them from?
I get them from people. They send them to me and my relatives, my grandmother.
I love when my grandmother sent me frogs, John, yeah. I tell you.
My name is Frog. They never send me people.
He actually came here. He wants a kiss from Audrey. Who knows what will happen?
You know? That's right. He's my handsome.
Well, I guess the moral of this for everybody at home is to keep those frogs and letters coming in. And now, Fred Casher, let's play Hollywood Squares. Now, we have kind of an unusual situation today. Our defending champion was here for 5 days, which is the legal limit. Therefore, we have a new player with us. However, she is not, in fact, so new. Her name is Laurie Goss. She was a contestant earlier, and in fact, a champion earlier. She won for 2 days, and on her third day, there was a bit of a problem. There was a bit of a question, in fact, about one of the questions. It may have affected the outcome of the game. Therefore, we have invited her back, and she is with us today once again to play Hollywood Squares. Good to see you again. And we're going to play Hollywood Squares until you hear the Time's Up bell. Whoever's ahead at that time will be our winner. Goes on to play our super match for up to $30,000. Now, wow. Our first game is worth $100 plus $25 for every square that either of you captures. Our champion gets to start. Laurie, you're in the champion's seat. That means it's your privilege. Pick a star.
Okay, let's start with Gene Rayburn.
Sure, let's start up with Gene.
Gene.
Yes, sir.
Who sits on emperor penguin eggs until they hatch? The male emperor penguin or the female?
Well, it's the female that has a larger, thicker layer of adipose tissue.
Oh, I'm so impressed.
Which she does not have. Stand up and show them that you have no adipose tissue on this body. You notice?
I'm not a female penguin.
Yeah. You're a female, though. Isn't she a female, fellas?
Yeah, she is. She's sight and
so therefore,
right,
because she has to fish in those very cold waters, it's the female who gets the food, and it's the male who sits on the eggs.
What was the question again?
Beats me. Okay, Gene says that it's the male emperor penguin who sits on the penguin eggs until they hatch. Agree or disagree?
I'm going to agree.
It is the male emperor penguin, and you are right to agree. You get the first square, and you get $25. Okay, Fern, your turn to try to get on the board. Pick a star for me.
I'm going to pick Arsenio.
Yeah, right on. That's a good choice. No, really, because people recognize me from this game. You know? Last week I was in Atlantic City, and a guy walked up to me and said, oh, you're the comedian. I said, yeah. He said, Nipsey Russell, my God. Go on, John.
Nipsey. Arsenio. I was the guy. Which contains more phosphorus, Arsenio? A box of 100 kitchen matches or the average cook?
The average cook.
Okay. Yeah. He says, more. The average cook has more phosphorus than a box of 100 kitchen matches. Agree or disagree, Fern?
I'll agree.
Yes, it is. The body of the cook. You were right to agree, and you get the square.
No, really, because that was unfair, because I majored in home ec. Really.
1X and 1-0, Laurie, pick a star for me.
Shawn, please.
Shawn Stevens.
Okay, are you ready? He's ready.
Ow! 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 Shawn!
I think
a lot of people in pain out there.
Ow!
They think the frog is a hunk, Shawn, I think that's... Oh, no, bad luck.
Okay.
Sean,
yeah.
According to Dr. Joyce Brothers,
yes.
The average man thinks about it almost 6 times an hour. Is it money or sex?
Excuse me, I'm going to consult with Lucky here.
Ribbit, ribbit.
He says, yeah, how'd you know? No, he says sex.
Okay, so Sean's frog says that the average man thinks about...
I didn't
about
say that, Grandma. Excuse me. It's the frog.
The average man thinks about sex almost 6 times an hour. Agree or disagree, Laurie?
I'll agree.
Yes, it is. Sex 6 times an hour. Are you right to agree? You get the square.
It's definitely a... Well, I can't say that.
That's right, you can't.
Your frog sure knows his men, Sean. Okay. Fern, make your move.
Audrey to block.
Uh-huh. You get this, you do block. However, if you miss this one, Laurie will win the first game. Audrey.
Yes.
There are bulges in your bra.
There most definitely are.
My 6 are used up.
How did they get there?
There's a long time left to this hour, isn't there? Okay, Audrey, there are bulges in your bra. Does that mean the cups are too big or too small?
No.
You might want this for some help.
There are bulges in my bra.
True. Well, yeah. Okay. It's one's bra.
What do you mean, lumps? You mean lumps?
Lumps or bulges?
Bulges.
Bulges.
That's it. But yeah,
that's a natural condition.
You know the answer to this, Audrey.
Yes. Okay. That means...
I think, yes, it's bulges beyond the usual.
Oh.
Does that mean the cups are too big or too small, Audrey?
I would say they're too small.
Okay. Fern, she says that bulges in your bra means the cups are too small. Agree or disagree to block?
I will disagree.
It does mean that they're too small. No, she should have agreed. Your opponent gets the square and wins our first game. Okay, Laurie, you're up to a good start. You got $175 so far, $25 for you, Fern, but don't worry, there's plenty of time in this hour left. We'll be back, you'll be back too.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Thanks. All right. Our next game is worth 200 smackers and $25 for every square that you capture. The last game was won by Laurie. That means Fern gets to start this one. Pick a star for me.
Jim up in the corner.
Jim Staahl.
Is that his last name up in the corner?
Yeah, I did this. I came on this show so that people would know that it's me and not Ed Begley Jr.
Okay, Jim Staahl. Begley Jr. Jim Staahl, who produces more milk in a day? Got choices. Your average nursing goat or your average nursing woman?
You know, it's so hard to choose anymore when you want a lot of milk. I think, and I read a lot of Field and Stream, so I know about this thing. The average, it's the goat, because it sounds like a trick question, but it's the goat.
Okay, Fern, he says that your average nursing goat produces more milk than your average nursing woman. Agree or disagree?
In one day,
yeah.
I'll disagree.
It is your average nursing goat who produces more milk. You should have agreed with him. He knows. He reads Field and Stream. Okay, your opponent gets the square.
And a goat looks nice in a white dress.
Thank you, Blake. Nursing. Laurie, pick a star for me.
Nedra, please.
Nedra. Which came first, Nedra? Silly Putty or Polygrip?
Well, there's really only one I'm interested in. See what I'm saying? Silly Putty or Polygrip? I'm going to say Silly Putty.
Okay, Nedra says that Silly Putty came before Polygrip. Agree or disagree, Laurie?
I'm going to disagree.
Polygrip, in fact, came before Silly Putty. You're right to disagree, and you get the square. Okay, Fern, pick a star.
Arsenio to block.
Mm-hmm. Once again, if you miss this one, Laurie wins another game. Okay, Nipsey, Arsenio. According to Julia Child, what is the proper wine to serve with Kentucky Fried Chicken? A Chardonnay? A Beaujolais? Or the cheapest wine you got.
I once had MD 2020 and a biscuit with my chicken. I would go with the cheapest wine you can find.
Okay, Fern, Arsenio says that with Kentucky Fried Chicken, you should have the cheapest wine you can find. Now, agree or disagree to block?
I will agree.
It is a Chardonnay. No, you should have disagreed. Your opponent gets the square and wins another game. Three in a row. Three X's in a row, two games in a row. You're up to $450. Nice going. $25 for you, Fern. Don't worry, there's still time. We will return after these messages.
Your hand.
Okay, we're going to start a $300 game. You get the privilege of starting this once again. Fern, pick a star.
Blake.
Yeah. Hello.
Okay, Blake.
Yes.
Who was Playboy's first playmate of the month? Was it Marilyn Monroe or Maxine Wells?
I think it was Ronald Reagan. Oh, that wasn't one of the... Who was it? Oh, I got a frog now. Wait, he's going to tell me. Okay. No, it was Marilyn Monroe.
Okay, Fern, he says Marilyn Monroe was Playboy's first playmate of the month. Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
It was, in fact, Marilyn Monroe. No, you should have agreed, and your opponent gets that square. Yeah, Marilyn Monroe. Okay, Laurie, pick a star for me.
Okay, Shawn.
Okay.
Shawn Stevens once again.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Sex up.
Ooh.
Which came first, Shawn? Alka-Seltzer or America's first pizzeria?
Okay. That's cute.
The name brand Alka-Seltzer? I mean, or a generic kind of Alka-Seltzer?
Alka-Seltzer.
Alka-Seltzer.
Does that answer your question?
Yeah. The United States' first pizzeria.
Okay, he says that America's first pizzeria came before Alka-Seltzer. Agree or disagree, Laurie?
I'm going to agree.
The pizzeria came first. You are right to agree. Yes, you get the square. 1895 for America's first pizzeria, 1931 for Alka-Seltzer.
Hey, yeah, and Alka-Seltzer came the next year after the pizzeria by popular demand.
How right. Know, like, Sammy Davis Jr. wasn't making Alka-Seltzer someplace on the side and nobody knew about it.
Yeah.
You know? I mean, never mind.
Man, okay, Fern, make your move.
You stall to block.
Mm-hmm. Once again, you missed this one. Laurie gets another game. You knew that. Jim, you're at a dinner party and you see a bug crawling on your salad.
Call for the frog.
Call Shawn. And I get the frog.
According to Amy Vanderbilt,
yes.
Should you ask your host for a bugless salad, or should you just quietly squish the little guy in your napkin?
Well, that or say you're on a diet. I think that you're supposed to squish it very politely and discreetly with the napkin and scream, murderer, murderer.
Okay, Fern. He says you should just squish the little guy in your napkin if you see that bug in your salad. Agree or disagree?
Then eat it.
I have no manners. I will disagree.
You should just quietly squish him in your napkin. No, you should have agreed. Your opponent gets a square and wins a third game. 825-25. Okay, we're going to clear the board and move on to our next game. This one is worth $400. Fern, you get to start once again. Pick a star.
I will go with Shawn and the lucky frog.
Yes. They'd like to go with Shawn as well, apparently.
It's unbelievable.
Shawn.
Yes.
You've just taken up jogging. According to Cosmo, you are likely to have a temporary change in your sex drive. Will it increase or decrease?
While you're jogging.
I firmly believe that it will increase.
Okay, Fern. He says that your sex drive will increase if you take up jogging. Agree or disagree?
I will agree.
It will decrease. You should have disagreed, and your opponent gets the square.
I never run nowhere.
Jesus. All right, Laurie, she is helping you out, but you got to make a move on your own now.
Okay, Nedra, please.
Nedra Volz. Your new man mentions a dress in a store window that he thinks you'd look good in.
Could I?
How long has it been since you've had a new man, though, Nedra?
Oh, it's been about 39 years, I guess, something like that. It's a long time. It's longer than married life, I'll tell you that.
Okay. Well, imagine you had a new man.
Imagine.
And he mentions dress in a store window he thinks you'd look good in. According to Cosmo, should you rush right out and buy it, or does that make you look too anxious?
Well, if he thinks I look good in it, I'd go out and buy the little sucker.
Well put.
Okay, Laurie. Nedra says you should rush right out and buy the little sucker.
I agree with her.
You should rush right out and buy the little sucker. You're right to agree, and you get the square. All right, Fern. Pick a star.
Fred to block.
Mm-hmm. You know, if you miss this one, Laurie will win another game.
What does she care? She got $25.
I have to remind you, it's part of my job.
Buy a cup of coffee with that.
Before he made it as a rock star, Fred, was Chuck Berry a male nurse or a hairdresser?
What?
Before he made it as a rock star, was Chuck Berry a male nurse or a hairdresser?
I don't know. I honestly know that Richard Nixon is going into rock music. He is. Here is Richard Nixon in his salute to Rod Stewart.
Transitions.
If you like my body, and you like my
body. He asked me a question like that. Can you repeat that, please?
Yeah. Know anything about Chuck Berry?
Smooth segue.
Yes?
Before he made it as a rock star, was he a male nurse or a hairdresser?
I would say he was a male nurse.
Okay, Fern. Fred says that Chuck Berry was a male nurse before he was a rock star. To block, agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
He was a hairdresser. No. You should have disagreed. Laurie gets the square and wins another game. Laurie, you're on a tremendous roll, and that bell means that time is up. You are once again our champion, Laurie Goss. Good going. Wow. $1,300. Okay. You know what to do? Go over there, join Gene Rayburn, get set for your shot at the big money. Nice going. Fern. Yes, you did get one right. You have $25. Yes. Yes, Gene.
This poor lady has done so badly here. I'm just going to contribute a couple of bucks to the cause. There you are.
How'd you win, Gene?
$25 for capturing a square. $2 from Gene Rayburn. He'll tell you later what you owe him for that $2, Fern. But you have our thanks. You're a good player. You're a good player. You just ran into a tough opponent. Thanks for being on Match Game Hollywood Squares. And now the man who just gave up his last $2, Gene Rayburn.
Hey, John, here we go. Congratulations once again to Laurie. Nice to see you again. We'll be back with these beautiful people. And a go at the big money for her right after this.
Answer?
Now, here to play the Supermatch is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you very much, Gene. Here we go. Now, Laurie, you've been here before. You know how this goes. She, at this moment, has $14,175. But right now in the Supermatch, she could win up to $30,000. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Let's have a go at it. We polled a recent studio audience and got their best response to this. Blank Landers. Now, the top answer is worth $1,000. The second most popular answer is worth $500. And the third, $250. Now, you may call on any three of our nine beautiful people here to assist you in suggesting answers. Who do you want to call on first?
Let's try Audrey.
Let's try Audrey.
Okay. I would say Ann Landers.
You would say Ann Landers.
Absolutely.
All right.
How ironic.
Yeah, that's...
Okay, John.
Well, somebody's got to do it. I'll say Audrey Landers.
Someone has to do Audrey Landers, certainly. Oh. Why not you, John?
Blake.
Hello, Blake.
Hello.
How Landers. Is it up there?
Gee.
I got one.
Well, give it to him. Arsenio, give it to him.
Oh, yeah. Judy Landers.
Yeah.
Judy Landers. Audrey's sister.
Sister.
Right. So we have the Landers family and Ann. Those are the three. Oh, now, yes. At this point, you may choose one of... What's that?
She had a really cute one.
What's yours, Nedra?
I had Laplanders.
Laplanders. The people who live in Lapland are Laplanders. What are you lapping at? All right. Audrey, Judy, or Ann is your choice, or one of your own. What is your pleasure?
Let's go with Ann.
Let's go with Ann. Okay. Let's find out if Ann is up there, and if so, where. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $250 answer. Judy Landers is there. All right. What do you think is under the next one, audience? Audrey. All right. Let's slide the $500 response. You're right, audience. It is Audrey. So that means Ann Landers is on top, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go with a $1,000 answer. Yes, it is. Very good. All right, Laurie, now you have $1,000. You're going to play the head-to-head match with any star you pick. Now, each star has that number in front, a hidden number, a 10, a 20, or a 30. If you pick a star with a 10, we multiply your money by 10. One with a 20, we multiply by 20. And there's one star, and only one up there, who has a 30 in front of him or her. And if you choose that one, we will multiply your $1,000 by 30, which means you'll be playing for $30,000. That's easy to figure it out.
Wow.
All right, it's time to choose a star. Make your pick.
Audrey.
Audrey, all right. Would you grasp the tab in front of you there and pull it vertically in... Oh, there you go, with a 20. Very good.
20.
A 20. That means you're playing the head-to-head for 20 times $1,000 or $20,000. And I will get the question.
That's a lot of luck.
And I will put it to you. And Audrey, you write your response to this, and she'll give a verbal answer after you've finished. Here it is. Good luck to you. No help from you, please. Blank candy. Blank candy, C-A-N-D-Y. Are you ready? Would you put it in a slot, please, so your light lights up? There we go. Audrey is ready, Laurie. It's up to you to match her now for $20,000. What do you say? How do you fill in that blank? Candy.
Oh, I'm blank, but I'll go with lots of candy.
Lots of candy, and the audience is groaning. All right, what would you have said? Cotton candy? You like cotton candy?
I love cotton candy.
Not anymore.
Audrey?
I said cotton candy.
Oh, cotton candy.
The audience wins $20,000.
Give the audience the money. Yeah.
Give the audience a nickel, Bobby. Now listen, you picked up another $1,000. That means at this time you have $15,175. How about that? Good for you. We'll be back in a moment or so right after these messages. Here we go. Very quickly right now, we want to find out which celebrity had the big 3-0. John, would you take your place? Everybody grab the tab and pull right now. Who had it? Jim! Jim Staahl had it.
Well, there he is.
Big 3-0.
I had it, but I picked penicillin.
Listen, we'll see you tomorrow. Ready?
Yes.
We'll see you tomorrow, too.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Oh, I'll be here tomorrow.
We'll see you tomorrow.
Match game, Hollywood Square is our, and all of these 9 celebrities. Join us tomorrow. Thank you. Goodbye.
So long. A member of our studio audience will receive Fenris Citation Super Thin Quartz Watches, yellow gold tone case with black dial and jeweled crown, furnished by Fenris Watch Company. And because an answer was heard from the audience, a question was discarded and the program edited. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, a Mark Goodson television production. It's more.